Hello everyone, welcome to your projects. The most important goal of your projects is to learn and apply how to model. The exact project topic is secondary, but the goal here is to understand how to ask good scientific questions and how to answer them, how to begin to approach those questions. Now these projects are student-directed. That's you designing and guiding yourself with your team to find out good ways of answering those questions. You'll also have guidance from TAs as well as by faculty mentors. But the key element here is that you learn by doing. My name is Xaq Pitkow, and I'm in charge of the projects team along with an amazing group of people, including Athena, Eric, Marius, Paul, and Gunnar. And we're working with a lot of other people to make this happen, a huge dedicated Neuromatch Academy team, plus 250 mentors, some of whom have given some suggested projects that are going to be really fun for you to work on. So in this video, I'm going to tell you about how the projects are going to be structured. And over the next hour, you'll watch some videos about what Neuromatch Academy is going to provide for that structure. We'll start with the project schedule, which is this video, which is going to help you stay on track and facilitate your progress. Then we'll have some videos about some curated data sets, which you'll be able to access and use within those projects. And that will allow you to jump over some of the difficult parts of getting started in a project. We'll also have a video of the big picture content that you can expect to see in the Neuromatch Academy, so you can understand what kind of techniques you can anticipate learning about and when, and so you know what you should research on your own. And then finally, we'll have a video example of how you can take an idea that's very vague and interesting, but not scientific yet, and form that and refine it to find something which can be a quantifiable scientific question. So, like I mentioned, the students, that's you, you're going to be running the show here. You will have support from a TA. Each project will have about 30 minutes a day on average of TA support, and they'll be able to provide you with some high-level guidance and some coding suggestions. And you also always have the use of NeuroStars, that forum for feedback and help and comments. You'll also have expert guidance from mentors. So we have many faculty mentors who are excited about helping you with these projects, and they've dedicated 5 times per project, a 30-minute slot for each project. And this will help you, they'll help guide you to form answerable scientific questions. They'll be able to suggest techniques, literature to look at, things to troubleshoot, some controls that you should run or check. And they'll be matched to you based on their availability and the topics of interest, just like you were matched with your pods based on topics of interest. There will also be an additional opportunity that many faculty have dedicated time for one-on-one meetings with faculty mentors, and that will be scheduled outside of the Neuromatch Academy time, but associated with it. So that will be a great resource for you to draw upon as well. Let me give you an overview of how the projects are going to flow. So week one is mostly dedicated to finding a good project. In the beginning, you'll brainstorm lots of ideas. You'll form project teams based on the affinity of who likes what type of project. The group should be about 4 people in each team. And then you'll spend the rest of the week refining the ideas and coming up with a proposal for the project. The second 2 weeks, weeks 2 and 3, you'll be executing those projects in your small groups. And you will prepare, and then at the end of week 3, present a short slideshow of your work in a poster session. And that'll be a lot of fun. You'll get to see what other people did in their projects. The project time is divided in time zones. So some people have project time before the course content, some people have it after the course content, and some have it split. Now, there are 15 days of course content, but there are only actually 14 project days. That's because there's no early day on day 1, and there's no late day on day 15. So you'll have 14 days to work on these projects. in week one, the first day, you're just getting to know each other, people in your pod. You talk about your interests, your research areas, and you know everybody's still getting used to the format. In day two, the projects, that's today, you're really going to start working in earnest to get a scientific project working. To brainstorm is the main goal of today. So after the videos, that's going to be a big thing that you're going to do. You'll spend the rest of your project time, maybe 3 hours, thinking about big ideas. And that's after you hear about videos of this video introducing the structure, some introductions to data sets and the course content, and thinking about how to refine ideas. So after you do this big brainstorming session with the whole pod, then in days 3 and 4, you're going to start to form groups and narrow those big ideas down into bite-sized projects, things that you could potentially do within the next 2 weeks. And at the end, you'll write a short proposal, which will facilitate us matching you with mentors who will be able to help you with that particular project. You'll also have a mentor on these refinement days, either day 3 or day 4, who will help you in that refinement process. And then day 5, it's time to go. Yes, implement, make it happen. Now, at the end of the week, all groups really have to finish by the end of the Thursday before the last day. Or if you're in early, if you're in an early time zone, you can do it on the morning before you start the course content on the last day. I want to emphasize that a complete project is more important than a spectacular one. This is only 2 weeks. This is not a PhD thesis. And so you should have reasonable expectations for what you can do and try to make that happen. And your goal here is learning how to refine ideas and how to figure out what techniques to apply, to learn more about those techniques, those kind of details. So whatever you come up with, whatever learning experience you have, that's great, and you should present on that. It's not like a huge discovery necessarily, although that would be fun too, but it's more like, what did you learn? What were the challenges that you faced? What was the experience like? And that's what we would like you to make your poster presentation about. And then at the end of the week, we'll upload that on a poster session server. The details of that are still being worked out right now. And then we'll have live presentations on the second half of the last day, which will include time for live interaction and Q&A. And those posters will stay available for later so that you can see more than you had time to see on that day. Okay, now, one of the key elements of coming up with a good project is brainstorming. So we're going to suggest that you use these boards for brainstorming in this remote context. So these are Miro boards, and your TA will establish a board, and you can have unlimited people logged into the board and creating little stickies or drawings and moving things around. It's a lot of fun, actually. You can see all the cursors of other people who are interacting, and you can read what they're writing and move things around and organize and use your own brainstorming. So there's going to be a fun brainstorming session that's centered around this that will help you organize your thoughts as a big group, as a pod. That brainstorming follows two basic phases. The first phase is an expansion phase and then a contraction phase. The expansion phase is really free flow. The goal is to get as much down on paper as possible, no judgment. You're not saying, oh, that's a bad idea, oh, that's not practical. Anything goes. You just want to get more creative ideas, improvise, respond to each other. And it will begin with some quiet time, some independent thinking, where you just by yourself making little stickies and writing down ideas of things you think would be interesting, fun, maybe important. And then after 15 minutes, everybody comes together in your pod and each person describes one or two favorite ideas that they had for like a minute each person. And then during that period, it's good to respond to each other and say, yes, that's a good idea. And oh, that makes me think of something else. And then you can add to the idea. Then at the end of that, you can start to collect ideas based on their similarity or their affinity. And then you can discuss them and reorganize and think about them different ways. Divide into different breakout rooms for 10 minutes, two times. Randomly divide so that you're grouped with different people, you get a fresh perspective, and you come back together and you discuss and you organize. Now, after that brainstorming, expansive flow, free flow, creative period, it's time to become more practical. And this is a contraction period. So then you start to say, okay, this is going to be practical in this period of time. This is, you can modify the ideas, you can synthesize them, combine them, prioritize. This is the most important thing to do. This is less important, that would be fun, but if we have time, we could do that. What's the most realistic, but still stay positive, because this is an experience that you're going to learn from. So what are the best opportunities for learning during this period of time? You'll have about 20 to 40 hours for the projects, depending on how things go for you. Then in days 3 and 4, you'll start to form those groupings, the project groups. And this is something you want to find by consensus. You want to gather people who are happy working on the same project. So you have all those ideas on the Miro board, and it's time to say, okay, this is what group one is going to work on. This is what group two is going to work on. And then people can drag their names under these things. If a lot of people like one group and there are too many people, you might split that group up. And those ideas, they can be drawn from the brainstorming session that you have, as well as from a number of project examples that we provide, which I'll talk about in a second. Okay, so then everyone will be moving their names around, and that will be the way that you self-organize into different teams. Like, I'm going to be associated with the Solve the Brain team, and Eric and Tittypat are going to go over into the Make a New Brain team. Fun projects. These are all going to be things that people like to do, but different people have different preferences. Now, when you're grouping, first of all, teams of about 4 are what we've found to be ideal. So you should aim for that. You should also make sure that expectations are communicated clearly, that the people in your team should have compatible expectations of how much time you're going to dedicate to the project. And people are going to have different perspectives. That's a good thing. You want to embrace diversity. You'll probably have a mix of people with more quantitative or more biological experience, and that can really be helpful. Also, there are different personal styles and different cultural backgrounds, and you want to make sure that as you're interacting with this, just like being a good Neuromatch Academy participant, that everyone respects those differences and savors them and values them. And make sure that you support your teammates. You want to give everyone a chance to speak, give everyone a voice and a chance to have their opinions heard. This is really important for engaging with the other people in your team so that no one person does all the work and no one feels left behind. So be sensitive to these things. But we know that you're here because you all love this science, and so we're confident that everyone's going to have a good time. Still, if you feel like there's some troubles, please speak up, talk to your TA. Reach out to one of us. We want to make this a good experience for everyone. Now, in addition to the structure that we're giving you for these projects, we're giving you some other resources to draw from. So in particular, we have some project examples that you can use to get ideas flowing. We have a slide deck, which has a standard set of tools. You'll hear more about that later. And you want to look at those after you've had a chance to do some brainstorming on your own, so that you have a chance by yourselves to think freely and unconstrained by what other people say is good. We also have some curated data sets for you, and this will be very handy because a lot of difficulty in getting a project started is putting data into a format where you can actually analyze it. So that part has been done for you for a few data sets, and we have videos about those data sets that you'll hear later on today. And then we also have, as you've heard in the first 2 days of content here, the how-to model structure, a way of thinking about what it means to model a system. And so on day 5, we'd like you to go through those 10 steps that we described in this how to model section. And we have the eNeuro paper that you can look at. This is going to be a useful exercise for you that will help you structure the work that you're going to do over the next couple of days. couple of weeks. So some final thoughts here about the structure. Projects are a key part of summer schools. And these are experiences that help you forge relationships with other students and TAs and the mentors that can last a long time and be really rewarding and just keep giving back over time. Now, this is different. Because of the pandemic, we're doing this over Zoom. And so this is very much an experiment. So keep us updated about how things go so that we can improve things both this year and, you know, for next year as well. Now, about the projects, you're doing science. You're working on things that are hard. And most of what we try in science doesn't work out. That's okay. If it were easy, it wouldn't be such an endeavor, right? But you're going to learn even when things don't work out, even when they come up with surprises that you didn't expect. You'll learn a lot from those challenges. And so that's what we want you to do. And enjoy the process of asking and answering fun scientific questions. Okay, that's all for right now. And you have more videos awaiting you soon.